Norway's crazy megaproject shocked American engineers. From the days of the long-distance traveling Viking boats to modern-day skyscrapers, Norway has contributed its fair share of world-class engineering. Now, a Norwegian megaproject has shocked not only American engineers, but the world as a whole. Keep watching this video to find out what this project is and more. What you need to know. The Sotra Connection PPP project, a 2 billion euro consortium led by Sotra Link, is the largest road contract in Norwegian history. The 9.4-kilometer four-lane road link between Bergen and Øygarden municipality in Norway's Vestland county will be financed, designed, built, and operated under a public-private partnership contract. Among its many amenities are a twin-tube tunnel measuring 4.6 kilometers and a four-lane bridge stretching 900 meters. In addition, three shorter bridges will be constructed. The first quarter of 2023 is the commencement date for construction. Macquarie Capital owns 70% of Sotra Link, while SK Ecoplant, a South Korean civil engineering firm, owns 20%, and the Italian industrial conglomerate WeBuild owns 10%. The Norwegian Public Roads Authority selected them as their preferred bidder last year, and they'll be responsible for the link's operation and maintenance for the next 25 years after it opens to traffic in 2027. FCC Consortium, WeBuild, and SK Ecoplant of Spain will carry out the design and construction of the over 1 billion euro project. Hungarian company Intertoll, through its Norwegian subsidiary Intertoll Norge AS, will manage the toll road. Both contract value and contract form and complexity are exceptional, said Ingrid Dahl Hovland, Director General of the NPRA. Mark Bradshaw, Macquarie Capital's Global Head of Infrastructure and Energy Capital, said, "We understand the communities of Vestland County have been waiting for a long time for this vital road link. And with today's financial close, we celebrate the next significant milestone of this exciting project." Speaking after the SK Ecoplant reached financial close, CEO Kyung Il Park said, "We are about to take the several years journey to construct an infrastructure of high municipal interest, and we are going to make the utmost effort to deliver the project on schedule and with the best quality to the community." The E39 Coastal Highway. The Storting intends to eventually upgrade and connect Kristiansand and Trondheim via the E39 Coastal Highway. The NTP 2018 to 2029 lays forth a set of expenditures over the following years. The Eigens Tunnel in Stavanger opened in April 2020, and by the beginning of 2021, about 10% of the anticipated work had been accomplished on an enhanced and ferry-free E39. The first project to replace ferries is called Rogfast. Upon completion, it will be the longest and deepest undersea road tunnel at 26.7 kilometers. The total budget for the project is NOK 16.8 billion, and it is expected to be finished by the year 2033. Fjord crossings south of Bergen, including those in Bjørgenfjorden and Langunen, and in Nordfjord, are currently in the planning stages. The Romsdalfjord and Junsalit Bridge has been cleared for construction. Measurements of waves, currents, and winds are currently being compiled in preparation for the passage of the Sulafjord and Halsafjord. Western Norwegian cities will become more accessible once the construction of a new and enhanced coastal highway route E39 eliminates the need for ferries. The development of Norway's greatest export region will be bolstered by the interconnectedness of large corporate locations and the housing, labor, and service markets. The project is around 1,100 kilometers long and connects the southern city of Kristiansand with the northern city of Trondheim, Stavanger, Stord, Bergen, Førde, Lisund, and Mold are also connected by this highway. The journey today takes over 21 hours due to the 7 ferry connections. A better E39 that eliminates the need for ferries is the goal, cutting travel times in half. Almost 50 kilometers will be cut out of the journey. Reduced travel times are possible through the use of fixed ferry links or more regular boat departures, as well as by the improvement of roads connecting the fjords along the route. What this project needs to succeed. An enhancement for all of Norway's western region will be made possible thanks to the Coastal Highway Route E39 project. Through the use of cutting-edge technology, the NPRA is opening up new possibilities for navigating the fjords. Specifically, the following factors have been taken into account for this project: safety, location and weather, functioning and repairing, engineering of structures, certification in technology, the science of materials, vehicle engineering, forces of nature, wind, waves, current, finance and society, a contractual methodology, predicting how transport systems will behave. Norway offers lots of large infrastructure projects. For the new E39 between Allesund and Molde, the Norwegian Public Roads Administration will put up between 20 and 25 contracts for bid. Upon completion, the five phases of the E39 improvements will create one residential and labor market, connecting the fjord town of Molde with the port city of Allesund on the country's west coast. A number of bridges, tunnels, both single and multi-lane, roads, two and four-lane, and a tunnel beneath the ocean are all on the list of planned construction. The amount of the contracts being offered for the works ranges from the low hundreds of thousands to over 4 billion kroner, which is about 390 million euro. The Romsdalsfjord Tunnel and the Julsund Bridge, the two largest contracts being offered by NPRA, will each feature a dedicated lane for walkers, cyclists, and automobiles traveling at a slower pace. The project manager at NPRA, Harald Inge Johnson, remarked, "This is a good and significant project. The number of contracts is far larger than the number of parts in the design, since we have subdivided it." At an upcoming conference, NPRA will brief contractors, subcontractors, and consultancies on the E39 Allesund-Molde project in an effort to get the new European route opened in 2030. According to Johnson, the NPRA has developed good solutions for bridges, tunnels, and the rest of the road through hard work. "We are eager to open up communication with the building sector at this time. By working together, we can create a stronger, more Og Romsdal." The E39 Lessened-Molde road construction is an initiative of the Norwegian Parliament's Storting National Transport Plan. Improvements to the transportation system are budgeted for at roughly 80 billion kroner, about 7.8 billion euro. The current E39 route spans a total of 1,330 kilometers from Trøndelag in Norway to Nordsvi in Denmark, although the primary goal of the improvement works in Norway is to allow for travel along its coastal region without the use of ferries. The E39 will be executed in five stages. First will be the Allesund-Digernes route, followed by the Digernes-Orgensfjellet, Orgonesfjellet-Vik, Vik-Julben, and Julben-Molde. According to the NPRA, in close cooperation with Møre og Romsdal County Administration, a new county road to Gossen will be constructed across the Strait of Kjerringsundet. This road will connect to the existing Allesund-Molde route. This will allow one to bypass the need to take a ferry over the Romsdal Ford. Connecting Otria, Media, and Gosen to the mainland will occur simultaneously. As a result, three ferry routes will no longer be needed and will be eliminated. A total of 75 kilometers will make up this section of the E39. What about the LÆRDAL tunnel? This is a road tunnel that runs for 24.51 kilometers, connecting LÆRDAL and Aurland in Vestland County, Norway. It is about 175 to 200 kilometers northeast of Bergen. Two lanes of European Route E16, the primary highway between Oslo and Bergen, that avoids ferry connections and treacherous mountain crossings in the winter, pass through the tunnel. After the Swiss Goddard Road Tunnel, this one is the longest road tunnel in the world. The Norwegian Parliament established Fjellafjell as the primary route between Oslo and Bergen in 1975. Legislation authorizing the construction of the tunnel was passed by Parliament in 1992, after it had already confirmed the original decision and decided the route should pass through a tunnel connecting LÆRDAL and Aurland. Construction on the tunnel began in 1995, and it finally opened to the public in the year 2000. The LÆRDAL tunnel's detailed plan. Between 1995 and 2000, workers excavated a total of 2,500,000 cubic meters of rock from the tunnel. The tunnel passes through a mountain range from Aurland's Aurlandsvagen to LÆRDAL's Lærdalsjøri, a distance of around 5.5 kilometers. It is broken into four sections, separated by three enormous mountain caves every 6 kilometers to ease the mental pressure on drivers. Lights in the main tunnel are white, but in the caves, they're blue, and at the cave's edges, yellow lights provide the sense of a sunrise. The caves are designed to provide a welcome diversion from the usual, giving weary drivers a chance to rest and enjoy the scenery. During the claustrophobic 20-minute trip through the tunnel, drivers can take breaks and make a U-turn in the caves. There are mileage markers every kilometer of the tunnel, both for how far you've come and how far you still have to travel. The LÆRDAL tunnel already proves the Norwegians' innovative way of thinking and gives us high expectations for the new E39 to be just as impressive. Thanks for watching.